Everyone, welcome back to another episode. This story is going to be in soon, so I hope you will love it. And Ang went out of Jimin's house. He sat in car and drove to Woo-sung's hometown. Just want to go to his young. He want to see him that he loves him so much that he can't live without him. He don't want to feel the loss of his young. He want his relationship to be committed. He want to say, "Young, I am ready to engage with you." That's all he wanted to say. It's not like they don't have faith in Jungkook. It is more like Taehyung is first time getting all he wanted in his life, and now he don't want to lose it. And the vibe he get from that girl making him anxious and worried for his and his young's relationship. When Taehyung is in middle of way to home, thunder and lightning started soon. The rain also started to pour. Initially, rain is calm, but later it became heavy. God, why rain have to pour like this now? When I took right decision at right time with right thoughts, but everything wrong happening to with me. Why this is all happening? Just why? Today, at any condition, I want to talk with my young Taehyung, muttered himself in car. He stopped at his car because of traffic jam. Heck, this traffic jam thing frustratedly hit steering. He waited for the road to be clear up, but it never happened. It almost half an hour, then Taehyung slid his window and saw the person sitting inside the car beside his car. "Excuse me," Taehyung called other person. "Yes," the person said. "Why it is taking too much time? I heard the tree is fallen on the road which caused roadblock, so we have to wait for that until they cleared it." The other man said with sigh. "Taehyung, just not to him. He can't do anything now. He have to wait." Taehyung suddenly leaned on his seat. Jian Mansion, all the people in Mansion finished their dinner and now they are talking casually. That's when they heard thunder and lightning. Jungkook immediately took out his phone and started to call Taehyung, but his phone was not connecting. He tried again and again, same thing happening again. Mr. Kim looked at worried face of Jungkook and asked, "What happened?" "Uncle, I am trying to call Taehyung, but his call is not connecting," Jungkook said, still trying to call Taehyung. After a few more try and call connected, but Nathe was not picking up his phone. "Maybe he is sleeping," Mrs. Kim said. "No, uncle, he don't sleep without messaging me," Jungkook said. "Everyone now can see how worried he is for them. I will call security guard of our mansion," Mr. Kim said and took out his phone. He called the security guard. "Hello, sir." "Hello, young. Is Taehyung safely reached home?" "No, sir. Young master didn't came home here today." "What?" Mr. Kim said with shock. Then he looked at Jungkook and Mrs. Kim and said, "Okay, just inform me if Taehyung came there." "Okay, sir." Mr. Kim disconnected call and looked at Jungkook and said, "He's not at home, but where he can be at this time?" Mrs. Kim asked worriedly. "He usually sleep at this time and his mood is not good today. I should have fallen him instead of sitting here," Jungkook said while feeling guilty and angry. Mr. Kim thought for a minute and said, "Let me try Jimin's phone." "Put it on a speaker," Mrs. Kim said, and Mr. Kim nodded to him. I started to call Jimin. After a few rings, Jimin received call. "Hello, uncle. Jimin, is Taehyung there?" "No, uncle. He left half an hour ago." "You mean he was with you?" "Yes, uncle. He came here with me few hours ago with angry bald face. He told you something where he is going." "Jian mentioned he took my car, but he didn't reach here, Jimin," Mr. Kim said, worried. Worry in evidence in his tone. He looked at his surrounding, all people looking at him like they are expecting some good news. "Uncle, I think maybe he is in on his way. I will go and check on him. If he came there, please inform me. Jimin said, okay. Jimin, if you found him, do the same. Mr. Kim said, and Jimin just hummed and disconnected the call. Mr. Kim became silent once again, and while rubbing his temple, he thinking what to do. Let me try, Mrs. Kim said, and started to call him in first attempt the network is not available, in second attempt finally the phone started to ring. After two rings they have received, Mrs. Kim kept his phone on speaker. Then they heard hello mom. With that they also hear a crowd and horn of cars, but somehow hearing thanks first they felt their muscles relax. Mrs. Kim immediately replied, where are you baby? I am on the way mom, but I got stuck in traffic. Thanks said, tell me your location. This time Jungkook talk young it's and the call disconnected. God, what the heck? Jungkook said frustratedly. He didn't know what he should do. He should be angry at himself because he let them go from house. He has chance to stop him, or he should be angry at the situation. For any normal person it is common to rain and stuck, but Jungkook is feeling something off. Jungkook can't stand and sit. He is walking back and forth. Then he heard, turned to his family and said, I will go and check on him. It's raining outside. It's not going to be okay, but he knows he's good to go now. We will be wait for him, the rain to be stopped. Mr. Kim said calmly. He knows he is saying that. He just want to do the same. But he knows his son is not that weak to not overcome with this small issue. I can't wait, uncle. I'm going. Jungkook said and rushed out from home without listening what his mother is saying him. Thanks be a wee word. When I was waiting for the road to be clear, one of the traffic police officer came to the location. He announced that all the people who are waiting for road to be clear, they should leave their car and here and they can go their home. It will take time to be clear the road. I am just so frustrated. My phone is dead and Jimin's car don't have charging pin for my phone. Second, it's raining and I have to walk in that. Anyway, I decided to go home by crossing this small street which take me to another road and there I can get bus. So after locking Jimin's car, now I am going through the road. Good thing about people who are also stuck in car like me. Whatever it is, and just hope I would clarify things with him. Ask him about his liking towards me and all. The burden of my thoughts are heavier than the heavy rain drops. Finally, I am here. I am muttered to myself. I think this rain is making me crazy. Almost all people came with me, went to their way. Only me and the other two men are standing on the bus stand. Oh God, I am completely cold. Now I am feeling trembling. I know my immunity is weak and only drench in rain of half an hour make me like this. I never knew that because of my mom never allowed me to go drench in cold water. Thinking about my condition, whatever happening with me, if I want to blame someone, it is me. Yesterday, Hyung already told me to have a talk with our parents about engagement. Still, my stubborn bump made me to go to the bar. So ultimately, convinced of my own pathetic condition, it is me. Kim Tae-hyung, what the silly is happening to me? I am feeling dizzy and everything around me is spinning. Those men are running towards me and time escape. I slowly open my eyes and realize where I am. I think this place has a gravitational force. I think it's my third time here, waking up in this mansion without knowing how I reached here. Then I heard bathroom door opened and saw Hyung is coming out of the room. I think he is still don't know I'm awake, so I called him. Hyung, he immediately came to me as fast as he can. How are you feeling now? Are you okay? Are you feeling dizzy or cold? He asked me, touching my forehead, looking at in my eyes. In single breath, I felt pang in my heart every time Hyung cared for me like I am his world. But every time I failed, look, those eyes who love me with purity and I am without thinking about him, always try to do as I wish. Baby, why are you not talking? He asked me while caressing my cheeks. I don't know what to do. I try to sit up, but I feel so weak. Why am I so weak? Why I really want to cry now. I look at Hyung and he asked, do you want anything? I nod to him and said, can you hug me? I can't able to sit, I said, looking at him with my miserable condition. Then Hyung climbed on the bed and slept beside me while tightly hugging me. Then I remember I have something to ask Hyung. Hyung, I know I want to ask you something. Baby, we can talk tomorrow. No sleep, he said, caressing my hair. No, Hyung, I want to talk to you now, I said, adjusting my head on his head. Now I can clearly see his face. Talk to him, looking at him, his eyes. He said, okay, tell me. I said, and Hyung's eyes became wide and his body became crispy. After few seconds, he relaxed and said, I will tell you, but before that, can I kiss you? Hyung, you don't have to ask. Before I can complete my sentence, his lips are crushed with my pulpy lips. He kissed me and so gently, like he is kissing me with more passion or rougher. My ribs will melt. This kiss is so smooth than I thought. His touch tongue into my mouth, but my disappointment by he broke the kiss, like understood my thoughts. He winked at me and said, next time I hit his chest. He really liked to tease me. So then the thing is, I fell in love with you when I was kids. I don't know exactly what is, but when I was in 11 years old, I realized that I want to be with you forever. So the thing is, I fell in love with you when I was a kid. So I don't know exactly at the age, but when I was 11 years, I realized that I want to be with you forever. Jungkook said, and Taehyung is shocked. No, shocked is underestimate. There is no word to explain his facial expression and emotional state. Taehyung never in his dream thought Jungkook loves him since when they were kids. Here he is conflicting about feelings at the age of 20s. How can Jungkook love him since then? How can Jungkook wait for him all these years? Am I dreaming now? Or Hyung is really speaking? Taehyung muttered to him, but Jungkook heard that and smiled to him. You are a really cute baby, and I am really speaking, Jungkook said, looking at Taehyung. Then why don't you tell me, Hyung? Taehyung asked, because when I wanted to tell you about my love, you already went to your grandmother's hometown and I went to study, so I don't get time to confess you, Jungkook said, remembering how his college days when he reached his teammates. Taehyung, whenever he sees lovers in campus, he always wanted to be like them, but he can't be able to do that. Taehyung thought for a while and said, then how you convince our parents for marriage? Taehyung asked Jungkook, because somehow he got the point that it all was planned of his. Hyung, I don't convince them. They already knows about that I am in deeply love with you, Jungkook said, and Taehyung exclaimed, what? Then why didn't they told me when they knew about this? When I was leaving to abroad for studies, my mom saw my diary and she told everyone. I thought Mrs. Kim, uncle, will kill me, but he is the happiest person when he knew I am in love with you. He even told me he will support me. He told me first complete study and then take responsibilities of company. Then he will give me your hand in to me, and uncle really supported me. Jungkook said, remembering how his uncle explained everything about Taehyung and Phone when he is in abroad. That is why he is so excited to make you his son-in-law, Taehyung said. Now he knows why his mom always supports Jungkook, because he is the person who loves Taehyung more than himself. When I was in abroad, I regularly call uncle. Uncle, tell me everything about you, your favorite food. Where were you? What were you doing? He told me how successful you became. I should be thankful to uncle. Due to him, now I am successfully able to court you. You are finally in my arms, Jungkook said. Now Taehyung is at the verge of crying. Jungkook looked at him and said, why are you crying, baby? Did I say something wrong? Taehyung shook his head and bit his lips while trying to control his tears, but always anyways, tears fall from his eyes. Young, why you love me so much and am I so dumb, Babu? I don't understand your love. I only know it's running away from my own conflict. I don't know, Young, I will be able to give you the love you which you are giving me. I even don't know, am I deserving one for you or not? I have problem with trust. I am clumsy. I can't make clear decision. I have a fear crowd. And Jungkook embarrassed Taehyung and said, you are the one who deserves my heart. I can't control my heart. It's already yours. And you know, no one is perfect in this life. Even me also. You are cold. I am warm. You don't like crowd and I don't like people get in my personal space. You don't know how to speak with new people. I can speak with people, anyone rudely. That means we both have good and bad things in each other, don't you think? God bring us together because we are made for each other, Jungkook said calmly, because he don't want his baby to feel insecure and inferior in this relationship. Young, I'm sorry, Taehyung said, and sobbing his Young's chest was so. Jungkook said, patting Taehyung's head, I made you wait. I don't understand your feeling, Taehyung said in low voice. Then now you are fine. We are fine. You are mine and I am yours, Jungkook said happily. Yeah, Young, I am yours, Taehyung said. Jungkook's body sniffed and his heart started to beat very loudly. Taehyung is on Jungkook's chest, so he immediately recognized it. He knew that what he said made his Young's heart beat faster, so he kissed on his chest to where Jungkook's heart is beating. Then he snuggled in Jungkook's embrace. Jungkook, on the other hand, feeling hot in his body due to Taehyung's action. Baby, don't do that, Jungkook said. Young, I want to confess something, Taehyung said, still hiding in Jungkook's chest. What is that? Jungkook asked calmly. At the same time, he is excited because today his baby's mood is good and he is opening up to Jungkook and analyzing the situation. Now Jungkook knows that some good news is there. Young, I want to engage with you as mom and dad decided. Jungkook pulled Taehyung from his embarrassment and looked at Taehyung. Taehyung didn't look at him because he is very shy. Jungkook looked so happy that his baby agreed to get engaged with him. Really, you are really ready to engage me? To the engagement, Jungkook asked, making Taehyung look at him. Yeah, Young, I'm really, really ready, Taehyung said happily to his Young, who is acting like baby. Oh my God, I will tell mom, dad, and uncles about the news, Jungkook said and got up from his position. But Taehyung grabbed him weakly and said, Young, I know you are excited, but it's midnight, everyone is sleeping, Taehyung said, knocking some sense to Jungkook's mind, which is not working due to over happiness. Oh, okay, now let's sleep. I love you, Jungkook said and picked Taehyung's lips and closed his eyes, holding Taehyung tightly in his arms. I love you too, Young, Taehyung said and closed his eyes. Everyone, marriage Thakuk marriage is on the way. I hope you will love it, and this story is going to be insane. Bye.